Hi, my name is Steve Faulkner. This is Real Magic with you, and this is Thought of Cards Across by Morgan and West. So before we carry on, please like, subscribe and share. As I might have mentioned in another video, I've just added my whole lecture course to Card Magic Course. It's all from my professional repertoire and I share that in depth on cardmagiccourse.com, or you can buy that for 25 quid. All the links will be below. So here is the Thought of Cards Across. Right, hand out like that, please. Hand out like that. And I'm gonna deal you 10 cards each. Mm-hmm. Make sure I do this fairly, please. You're gonna get the reds. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10. You put your thumb on there, please. And you're gonna get the blacks. Okay. One, two, three, four. Make sure I do this fairly. Mm-hmm. Five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10. All right? So, what's gonna happen is you've got 10 each. You got the black cards, you got the red cards. You're just gonna look at one card out of these cards, all right? First thing you're gonna do is you're gonna look at a card from this pack of 10, but don't tell me what it is. Have you got one?
Yeah.
Do you know what it's called?
Yeah.
Okay. Put your thumb on there. So just look at one. Let me know when you've got one. Take your time.
Yeah.
You got one?
Yeah.
So you got one in your head? That's it, it's done. Done. So you had 10 cards.
Uh-huh.
Hold your hand out. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine. All right. Eight, nine. And you had 10 cards.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10, nine, 10, 11. You were merely thinking of a card. Is the card you were thinking of in now in this pack?
No.
Completely gone from the pack?
It's not there.
Not there. And you could have looked at any one of those cards. And yours was the two.
Yeah.
All right? Red. 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 And if you keep going, you got the red cards. Red. Six of spades, wasn't it? And yours with the two of clubs, which is the only one that you...
Oh, gosh. I just don't understand how you do it.
So I first saw this at Blackpool, and I liked it. I love the cards across routine. It's always something that plays big, isn't it? It works on stage, it works on close-up, it's got that width to it, so you can use the whole table, and it's a great parlor routine. So I'm always looking at and interested in these routines. When I saw Morgan West do it, obviously there's two of them. If you've not seen Morgan West stuff, you should check it out. It's brilliant. And I will say that if they bring something out, I kind of trust it, because they are workers. They have come into this as performers who have created a trick that they do. So I'll say that to start off with. I'm not a fanboy, but I really like their stuff. They've performed for my show up here, and there's a professionalism about them. You know, they know their theatre, and that when people like that bring out a trick, I sort of perk up a little bit. Now, there was part of me when I saw them do it, because they're such a strong double act, that, you know, when they lectured, they said, and you can do this on your own. You don't need a double act to it. But it seemed like a double act trick. And when people say that, I kind of got that. And I think the reason it's been sitting on my shelf for so long is because, you know, when you play a board game, right? Let's say you play a board game, Risk or something like that, and it's built for three or four or five people. But in the instructions, it says, but there's a version where you can play with two people. And it's never as good as it. It's like a kind of slightly lame version. And I think subconsciously I was worried that this, because it was built for a double act, that I wouldn't, the version that you do on your own isn't going to be as strong. It's totally as strong. It's pretty much the same trick. It's just one person does it. So let's go straight into the pros and cons. No sleight of hand in this. Now, it doesn't mean you don't have to do something. You do have to do something. But there's no kind of second deal, fourth count that you've got to go off and learn. You're pretty much going to, skill-wise, you're going to be able to do this out of the box. meaning you don't have to spend 3 weeks learning something. That's one thing. The other thing is, it is a very, very, very strong effect, isn't it? If you think about it, it's, you know, that Di Vernon thing of, can you describe the effect very easily? Yeah, I thought of a card, it was in these packs and it went over and then they had it and it vanished from this pack. It's very easy to remember, even if it's not in detail, and it plays really big, you know? I love it when things, when you can kind of talk out here and you're not down here. You're talking to this person, talking to this person, talking to the audience. And I love that. It creates this sort of tablet, this image, which is really, really important. There's no angles in this, by the way. So you can have people sitting at a table, one there, people behind you. There's really nothing to see. The tutorial's brilliant. Now, Morgan and West are genuinely funny on the tutorial. Now, you know when people try and be funny on tutorials, and it can be grating, can't it? Because unless you think of something funny, or unless you've got a chemistry that creates funny, it's painful. It's like trying to be, it's that sort of cocky funniness that people do that I find very, very hard to watch. No, I'm sounding like I'm getting a bit grumpy here, but with these guys, because they have got a chemistry and bounce off each other, I genuinely laughed in the tutorial. And when I'm watching this tutorial, that's important. Because there's some stuff to remember here. Now, there's no memory, as in it's not like a book test or something where you've got to remember a load of stuff, but obviously you've got to remember the process. And this is going on to the challenges now. And these aren't big challenges for me, these are what I would expect, but there is a process here. And for someone like me, it took me a while to get my head around why the trick was working. And they do say this on the tutorial. They say that make sure you learn how the trick works. Make sure you really get why it's working, how it's working. And with a trick like this, a little bit like Triumph, unless you really spend some time with it, you can, and if you do get stuck halfway through or you go blank, if you don't know how the trick works, you can be a bit screwed. So I would say that, I mean, even though the trick is easy, it's easy not, I said this about stasis, it's easy not to spend the time with it, but really go through the motions, you know. Do the couple of things you have to do that aren't really slights, but you have to do again and again and again and again so you get a feel for it. And that's what I would say, there is a feel to this trick. And when I performed it for the first time yesterday, I was nervous. And weirdly enough, I was more nervous than if I had to do a load of slights. I've said this before, I was nervous because I was sort of having to remember it. And I did get the shaky hand thing. But the great thing is, nobody's really looking at hand because there's no real slights. It's kind of like you're counting stuff. So even though I was a bit shaking, oh God, this is bit weird, it flew. And then the second time I did it, and the third time it was absolutely fine, and I started trusting the process. It is very, very magical. It's very clever the way it's done. And you know, it is good value. You know, you could put this together yourself, but as it says again on the tutorial, if you do that, you're going to spend just as much. So know that what you buy, and I don't really think it matters either way, even if you do buy something, you can bang up in 2 minutes. But knowing that what you buy is an investment, and you know, the fact you can do it is a lot less hassle and going to cost you about the same or less than if you got it yourself. The cards, incidentally, are put out by Card Sharp by Christian. So they're well made. There's two kind of different kind of card things going on here, but all really, really well made. So it's going to last you for a long time, but you're going to have to sort of refresh every now and then. I will say that the reset, this is really important. And it's at the end of review, which is apt, really. The reset is, that took me a while to get my head around, but if you watch the tutorial, Christian, like the tutorial is all by Morgan and West, but Christian does this thing at the end where he's played with it a lot and he comes out with some tips. Make sure you watch that. It will save you a lot of time. I would say watch the tutorial, Morgan and West, go straight on to watch Christian's tutorial and then decide how you're going to do it, because there's an instant reset, which is a lot easier. There's something in it that maybe doesn't play quite as well with the instant reset, but I think it's going to fly with the audience. And that was so, so useful, because that's when the penny dropped for me and I got it and made it all a lot easier. So thank you very much. That's Morgan and West TOCA, Thought of Cards Across. If you're into that kind of parlor thing, or you want to sort of use something that uses the whole table and a couple of people, I suggest you check it out and have a play with it. Thank you very much indeed. Please check out cardmagiccourse.com. It's a great way to support the channel, and it's not asking money for nothing. It's incredible value, especially as I've just done in my lecture. And please like, subscribe, share, do all that good stuff, and I'll love you forever. Any questions, comments, please do that down below, and have a great one. Cheers.